We are live from Medellin, Colombia, here at CEFA, the Circular Economy Forum of the Americas 2017. And we are accompanied by Rob Oman. He's from Sea Creators, the Netherlands. He has joined us to share his views and perspectives of circular economy, what they've learned in Europe, the Netherlands, and sharing the experiences with us here in Latin America, Caribbean, let's say the Americas. And so I'm going to just have a brief conversation with Rob to ask first of all about himself and who he represents, what Sea Creators does. And then the second question will be what he sees, what the potential is in the region for the application of circular economy principles. And finally, an invitation for next year, CEFA 2018. So Rob, yes. Welcome. To CEFA 2017. We're happy to have you with us.
Thank you so much.
Please elaborate about who you are and the entity you represent and why it is that circular economy is so important for your institution and where you're originally from.
For the world eventually, yes. Yes. Well, I've been involved in circular economy for about 4 years now. And then I started that I worked for an organization to develop new models on how to manage wastewater management better. And right now I'm working for Sea Creators. Sea Creators is an organization in the Netherlands that stimulates the transition to the circular economy, and we do that for businesses and local
governments
as well.
Yes.
What we mainly focus on, what we have learned in the past 3-4 years, is that working together in a supply chain in an early stage is very important to succeed in developing a new circular product or service, and that's what we help our clients with.
Okay.
Another element is the local governments in the Netherlands really want to support this transition to the circular economy, and I believe innovation on the city level is kind of key, and also the right level, because national is kind of too big to really move things forward, although it's needed as well. And what we do with local governments is we launch different multiple year programs, and we do that in specific industries. So construction industry is one of them at the moment. To really, together with organizations from the private sector, government, and research institutions and universities, work in an early stage on with per construction projects that are going on in a municipality to set the bar for circularity high in an early stage. That's in short summary how we move the transition forward, circular economy. Yeah.
Thank you. This is very interesting because, as you know, there are plenty of large cities in the Americas. Most of them are located near the shore or at the river system. Yeah. And there's a general trend that there's a lot of urbanization happening. And not everybody has access to suitable living conditions or stable infrastructure.
Yeah.
And on top of it, being in compliance with the circular economy principles.
Yeah.
So what would you recommend the region to start doing in order to profit of these great opportunities that circular economy thinking allows for?
Well, I think first of all, what we have learned in the Netherlands and in Europe over the past couple of years is that spreading knowledge in an early stage is very
important. Yes.
So that as many stakeholders as possible know about the concept of circular economy. Because what we have seen is that knowledge in the Netherlands has developed like throughout, but we did not really have the infrastructure in place that every new project or initiatives could build up on the previous knowledge. So I think that would be a recommendation. Other than that, I think a huge opportunity in the Americas in general. I think the Americas are really resource rich, and I think that in the basics offers an opportunity. I saw yesterday in a session as well that talked about primary resources, and how you add value, and that usually happens in other places around the world. And I think with circular economy in the concept in perspective, I think the Americas can really tap into the great resources that they have, and instead of selling them on, maybe continue to have ownership over those materials, and make sure they continue to stay valuable throughout their life.
Great, this is a very great point. Thank you, Rob. We will definitely include your recommendations in the final reporting that we are presenting for CEFA 2017. Thank you for participating in one of the sessions and sharing your knowledge and experience. And we look forward to having you with us next year in Santiago de Chile.
Santiago de Chile.
Cheers.
Me too. Thank
Bye-bye.
You.
Bye-bye.